Couple Panels Podcast. This is Kristen Arnold, and I am on a quest to make all panels lively and informative. And on today's podcast, I'm so excited. Tracy Gilliam, she's the SVP at Futuri, and I'm so excited because, Tracy, you were asked to moderate a panel at a very, very important All Access Audio Summit, and you'd never moderated a panel before. So love to hear your story, your experiences. So thanks for joining us, Tracy.
Oh, it's a real privilege. I mean, I was very lucky, and my first quest to do a panel that I had you as my coach and mentor. If I didn't have you, I don't know if it would have ended the same way. But I mean, the outcome was spectacular, but it was really, really all due to your direction and coaching. And obviously, I listened. I would say that's the very first thing that's most important is listening to you.
Well, thanks for that plug. I wasn't expecting that one, but I'll take it. So, Tracy, you've been on panels before. So, obviously, you know what they look like. And this was a virtual panel. So, it was a little different, right?
Right.
So, tell us a little bit about the event and how you were approached and what your initial reaction was.
Well, when I was approached, it was probably 2 weeks before the actual panel. Now, I don't know if that's typical that you'd have 2 weeks, so I have no idea, but that's about the time I had where our CEO and our SVP of Marketing and Brand Communication asked me to moderate this important panel. They thought I'd be great for it. I said, sure, of course, I'm going to say yes. Absolutely happy to. What are we talking about? And figuring, all right, that'll come next. And then I got the topic and I thought, okay, I can handle this. The guest lineup was small. It was a really great expert panel of audio experts and research experts, but they were top in their field, best in class. And it wasn't intimidating to me, but I realized that I had better know everything I need to know going into that panel to make sure I optimize their time and make it meaningful to the audience. So I didn't have a lot of lead time, but what I did get after I agreed to do it was a direction right to you to say, Kristen's going to help you and coach you through it. And that organization time that I had with you is what set me up for success. But at first it was a little daunting, a little overwhelming. I've been on panels before. Can't say I remember them fondly. And largely because it just, they weren't interesting or engaging or dynamic or memorable. How about that? Unless somebody got up and had a scene, there was nothing memorable.
Yeah. So you were on a quest to make it engaging, memorable, lively, and you had some pretty high-powered panelists. And now, how many panelists did you have?
I had four.
And how much time did they give you?
The whole session, I had 45 minutes.
Okay. So 45 minutes, and they gave you a topic. Mm-hmm. Did they give you any other information other than the name of the panel?
No, just basically the title of it and the a little bit of subjectivity from the summit host, the actual developer of the program, who kind of thought this is what I'm trying to do, or like the job to be done. A little bit of subjective insight to this is what we want to find out. But I also thought, well, I better probably look at this really objectively. I didn't want to come in with a preconceived notion. I didn't want to come in with my own itinerary or agenda, so to speak. I wanted to do my homework first and prepare for it, learn all I could to understand perspective, and then make sure that the questions I asked brought those different perspectives to light. And I be neutral.
Which is hard to do when you know a lot about that subject matter.
Right. I know a lot about the industry, but I had to take my hat on my head was moderator. That's it. It wasn't, what does Tracy think? You know, nobody cared about that. It was just leading them down the path of giving their expert opinion and feedback for the audience. And that's really what my charge was. And again, your preparation helped me. It was a little, you know, at first I thought, you know, how do I prepare for this? But then you sent me lots of links and books and PDFs that I could review. And I thought, okay, I'm going to have to go right to the virtual power panel training mode, because this was a virtual only event. The audience was virtual. The panel was virtual. I mean, it's a different age now, but I went right to how do I make that dynamic And how do I make it a very content robust experience and prepare, you know, properly for that?
Yeah. Okay. So I loved working with Tracy because she's a Hoover. She just like consumed massive amounts of information about how do I do this and how do I do this in a virtual world first. I really think that that was part of your success is you just said, I need to get my arms around what is a moderator? What's the role? What am I supposed to do? What do I not do?
Right.
And then when you figured out like, oh, okay, these are the key pieces, then I think that's when you went and touched base with the meeting organizer to get better perspective about what she was expecting.
Yes. What? Yes.
And, right. And then what happened? Like, this is what you had to do on your own. Like, right. How did you prepare for this amazing panel?
Well, you know, it's interesting. It is, you know, to many, it might be yeoman's work, but it was super important to prep. The first thing I did, and again, this advice came from you and what I read, but I went to our SVP, who's the one who helped facilitate this and asked me to moderate. And I asked her, you know, why this topic? What is it you're trying to accomplish? What is it we want the audience to do or believe? Give me some kind of context so I know why this group of people. Tell me why they were selected. Then I asked the same exact questions to the event organizer, and I got different answers. So I was like, okay, good to know. And then I reached out to each panelist uniquely to introduce myself. And I also sent, after speaking to each of them briefly, and many of them felt sorry for me, to be candid. They were like, oh, good. I'm so glad I'm not doing this. Most of them were like, please don't let it be me. I'm so glad it's you. And I'm like, oh, thanks. Yay. I'll do great. I was like, the more they said, I'm so glad it's not me, I was like, oh, great. More I went to you and said, help, make sure I rock this. So then I talked to each panelist uniquely in terms of, you know, just tell me about your business, what your observations have been, but not a lot of detail. I intentionally didn't ask them a lot of questions that would lead us to the content of the panel because I wanted the panel conversation to be new to me and make it interesting and not like it was pre-scripted because none of it was. So then I asked, after I got to know everybody, and this is happening really, really fast, the first thing I did was send out a questionnaire about like five things that we hope they want to accomplish and different questions related to that, that they could respond via email, and I collected. Mm-hmm. But that was probably by day three. So a lot happened fast because even though, I mean, we had a record within 2 weeks from the day I was asked to do it. And we were vying for a slot to record with about 10 other groups of people doing a panel. So we had to get our time or I was going to be doing the panel tomorrow. And I wanted some time to prepare and learn how to do it. And you know what's interesting is that I learned quickly is that the moderator better take control of the communication. If you don't, because you have other leaders on the panel and that are in the exchange of emails and are in this thread, they all will just answer questions independently and all say different things. And then I'm sitting here going, hold it, who's running this show? I think I'm supposed to be. And I'd have to pull everybody back and go, okay, hold it. I got this. I'm going to line up the time. I'm going to line up the session. I'm going to tell you when it's starting, when it's ending. I will make sure the technical is done. Everybody, don't worry. And then they all went, okay. And they all backed off. So that it was like herding cats at first.
Yeah. That's pretty typical. But I think you brought up a really good point is that they need to know that they're in good hands.
Yeah.
Trust. They need to know that you've got their back, that you're listening, that you're providing that kind of feedback and that you're going to make them feel good, look good, right. Say great things. So you've had conversations, you sent an email, you got some responses back. Now, how did you go about thinking through the format, the agenda run of show?
I followed your agenda outline or objectives from the panel, you know, powerful panels about having an objective, a welcome, have an agenda, you know, commit to the time, like know that your opening is X number of minutes. and know the format that you want. Do you want everybody on the panel to speak out of the gate, or do you want to ask a question and only throw it to one? I mean, there's a lot to think about, but once you decide, you just go with it and you commit to your plan because it needed to be really well orchestrated because we only had a certain amount of time. I mean, that was it. We didn't want to have to edit 2 hours of content down to 30 minutes because then anything could happen in the editing booth. What we wanted was a tight 45 minutes end to end with no editing. So it was real, it was organic, it was natural. And that was my goal. So I kept it tight. So the agenda was critical. We started with the moderator welcome. Then we went right into questions and everybody weighed in. I also told them beforehand to lean in if they have something to say. Like, don't wait for me to call on you. Lean in and I'll know it's for you. And if you don't want to talk, lean back and don't look like you're interested. And they did all that. They were funny.
Ah, that's good. That's good.
They were funny. They were really great. So they had an outline in advance, but they didn't know what I was going to be saying when. And they just, their personalities kind of came to life too. I made them comfortable. That's a big, big job of the moderators, to make them feel at ease. Mm-hmm. And they were great from, you know, beginning to end because of that. And we were all on camera the entire time so I could read their body language. Uh-huh. And that was important. So definitely have an agenda, have a set timeline, and know how you're going to wrap it all up.
Yeah. Okay. So let's go through a little bit of the specifics.
Sure.
Introductions. Did they introduce themselves or did you introduce them?
I introduced them because it would go faster. I was tired. I didn't want it to be a long, drawn-out intro of everybody on the panel. So I just did the introduction and I went right to a question as I introduced each of them.
Okay,
so it was open, then right to, let me go to XYZ, who's head of this, who's done this and this and this. All right, to you directly. Here's the question. Then I went to the next panelist and so on and so on. And repeated.
And each panelist had the same question or a different question?
Different ones.
Yeah. Did they know that first question?
Yes. Yes, they did. That was the only question that they knew in advance. Yeah, was that. And they each had their own unique question geared towards their expertise, of course. So it played to their reason for being on the panel.
Cool.
Versus some, you know, arbitrary thing I could come up with.
Okay, so now everybody's introduced. They've had like their first opening salvo question. Then what happened?
Then I went down a list of questions that I had prepared that they hadn't seen, and I chunked them in segments. So I had segment one, segment two, segment three, and segment four, and then, you know, one big takeaway. And this went fast, so I had to actually eliminate some segments. So I had more than I needed, but by design, so that I wouldn't come short of content. I'd rather have more than less. So the first thing was I asked, again, a pointed question to one of the executives that would start a conversation for others to weigh in. I knew who would respond, but I also said lean in and lean back so I could see who wanted to say something. And in the very first question, we had three people comment, which was great. And then after that, because most people were weighing in on the same topic, we had, I should have brought them with me, agree or disagree cards. And they're really impactful on a panel where you're on a stage, but it was even as important, if not more so important, on a video virtual conference. This was my preparation file for this panel. It's a lot of stuff, but I had lots of notes, but I found it, okay? So on the second section, I asked a question based on what everybody said, and I said, hold up whether you agree or you disagree with this comment that was stated by whoever that was at the time. And they held them up and they were printed and they were ready and they did it on cue. So simultaneously, they all held up their card and I evenly jokingly weighed in. I went, ah. Just for fun.
And so logistically, you emailed that out so everybody had the same thing that they were holding up.
And they had it printed in advance of the session.
Right.
Yes. I did trial balloon it a day before. And I said, here's what we're going to be doing in terms of, you know, why you need to have this handy, have it printed big enough to see, don't be shy. But I didn't give them the questions, right?
Cool.
It worked. And that was really fun. They loved it. So we did agree or disagree. And then we said, if we were to do this panel again, let's say 3-5 years from now, what would you hope would be different, you know, about what we're talking about, what would change between now and then? Then we did a segment on possibility thinking. And then we did one big thing, which is like a takeaway from the day. And then we went into Q&A, which was live in the audience. And that was all via chat mm-hmm. in the chat box, which was different too. And that is happening the entire session. So that was, as a moderator, you're multitasking. You're trying to stick to your agenda, you know, address all the things, follow the faces of everybody on the team, read the chat box, determine which questions you're going to broach or not broach, and do it all in real time and watch your time clock.
Yep. Yep.
So there's a lot of moving parts.
There are a lot of moving parts. So the feedback was awesome. What did you hear most in the feedback? What was most memorable? You wanted it to be memorable. You wanted it to be impactful. What were people's impressions and takeaways?
From the audience, it was engaging. It was very positive in the sense that they actually got something out of the session, meaning of content, takeaways, something they could use of value. And they learn something new, which is really important, I think, that we don't walk away going, that was a waste of time. But it was a good use of time, and that it was invaluable, and they had something they could apply.
So hang on there, because not all panels have that.
Oh, good. Okay.
So, not good, but yes. So what did you do to make sure that the conversation did have that application, did have new information? And by the way, for the listeners or the viewers, you know, this was a pretty controversial, could have been a very controversial topic.
Right. And so the topic could have very well been a big debate, and I didn't want it to be any kind of hostile thing. And I also wanted to make sure it wasn't going to be trite and the same thing we've heard over and over and over and over again. I wanted it to be different. And having been in the industry, I kind of knew all the things that have been said enough to where I felt comfortable to make sure that we got right down to the nitty gritty on real context of what can be done differently now. And I just was very direct and very candid and just said, you know, we need as an industry to know these things, and what is it, you know, give us direct answers. And I think that was part of it. I also asked for handouts in advance from the panelists if they had anything they wanted to share. And I reviewed it in advance, and I only used one piece in the entire panel that I shared. And that was from where the debate could have happened. It addressed it and kind of extinguished any controversy because I had this one handout that I was able to present. And that kind of kept everything very tempered and well-received, and people in the audience could use it.
So a lot of that occurs in the planning and the preparation, like really carefully crafting your questions, teeing up the topic, being very clear about your expectations, what you want it to be, what you don't want it to be. Now, some people would say, ooh, no, I want that controversial, heated debate. But in this case, for this situation, you go, no, that's not what the organizer wanted, and that's not what the person who asked you to do it wanted you to do. So I think there's a lot of pieces mm-hmm. that, you know, and I do think that you probably, if I remember correctly, you coached the panelists to say, we want new information and we want application. Like, what does this audience need to know that they can't get anyplace else, that they don't know already?
Yeah, that's absolutely true. Exactly. Because I didn't want everyone to think, oh, here's another conversation that I've heard before 1,000 different times. I mean, and never anything new. So I did say to them, based on your coaching too, you know, let's hear something we don't know, and let's give the audience something that they can actually take away and do something and apply in their own role and make it meaningful. Yeah. So that's why I think the audience got a value prop out of it, but I did have to coach them in advance. You're right about that.
Your final question. Yeah, there's a lot of moving parts to it. To do a panel really well, You have to be very intentional and think about it. Now, the last question that you asked the panelists, your summary question, what was that one?
The one thing. So that was the final question. It was, if there was one thing you want the audience to take away from this conversation, what would it be? And that was everyone's chance. And again, it was another way of, we did earlier in the panel, a one big breath where everybody could say in one sentence something, but this was also designed to be short. So, you know, literally was less than a minute per person and it was a wrap up. And then we went into Q&A. So
and if they know about that question?
I think I did say we're going to do a wrap up, but it wasn't scripted to them in advance. It just was, you know, we're going to have a takeaway comment at the end.
Okay. Nice way to put a bow around it.
Yeah, a good closing. And the one nice thing, I mentioned what the audience got out of it, but the best compliment I think I got from all the panelists were, great job. These are usually terrible and horrifying new experience. And you did a great job. I can tell you prepared. You were ready. You knew what you were talking about. You paid attention. You listened to everybody. The best compliment were these people that were so hard to impress, and they were impressed with just the experience. And they said they would do it again if I was hosting another one.
Aww, well, good job. That's like, yeah, amazing. Like,
that's good to hear.
that's amazing. So let's finish off this podcast. Thank you so much for joining us. Let's finish this off with, what's the one thing that you think the listeners, viewers should do if they're moderating their very first panel and want to hit it out of the park just like you did?
Get your help.
Oh, thank you.
For sure. Oh my gosh. Yeah, I just don't take it for granted. It is a big deal. It is such an important event. Don't take the quest mildly or lightly. Go in realizing this is show prep like no other. Spend your time on it. Take your time, really research and get the right coach to help mentor you, coach you through how to make it incredible. There's no reason to have mundane, lame panels in this day and age. There is no reason for it.
Amen, sister.
And there's no need for it when we have you. So, I mean, I'm happy to talk to anybody that listens to this to get my first time, you know, first time caller, long time listener experience, which is, you know, it was my first time and I really enjoyed it. In the end, I was confident going into the session. My panel was totally confident, not worried about me and throwing any wild cards that would get them caught flat footed. And it was all because of the preparation, no doubt about it.
Well, thank you. Thanks for sharing your story with us. The advice is priceless. And here's to your next panel.
Oh, yeah.
They said that they'd be on another panel with you. So why not?
Why not? I know we're actually going to have to do these in person now, though, because I think we're all going back into travel mode. So these may be on stage. So I'm going to need to step up my game even more if I'm live.
You know, I think that there's going to be a real blend.
Yeah, do you?
Because sometimes you're going to have a remote panelist who might be on the stage, but it'll be a screen that's taking the place of a panelist. You might have all of the panelists and a live moderator with a live audience. I mean, there's going to be all kinds of blended
ways. I think you're right. I think you're right. Like a hybrid.
Mm-hmm.
Hybrid approach. Yeah, I think you're right. Even those that for the conferences aren't saying they're all going to go in person, they may do virtual with some of the staff.
Yeah.
So that could be the new world, you know, order, and that's fine. But even more so to play to all those different audiences, if you're in person, if they're on video, and you have the cards, and you have to look at the questions, that's even more daunting for the moderator. Even more.
Even more.
So I better start reading your books fast in case somebody asks me to do it in a week.
Read my books. Well, I do appreciate the shout out. Appreciate your time and your story. And Tracy, thank you so much. And we'll be seeing you moderating another panel. For those of you who are interested, please Subscribe to our podcast on iTunes, Stitcher, or go see them on YouTube. So thanks for listening. Thanks for watching. And we'll see you at our next episode of the Powerful Panels podcast. Thanks for watching.
Thanks, Kristen.